Marking an offshore wind farm presents a unique challenge. Instead of standalone lights, we now have to tie together multiple components so that the entire wind farm looks like a single obstruction. As we worked on doing this, the first offshore wind farms quickly became large engineering projects. We felt that there had to be a better way. Why do we need to reinvent the wheel for every project? How can we simplify installation? And how can we simplify the commissioning process? We set out to answer these questions, and the end result was the NAI system and product range. NAI stands for Nav Aid Interface. The NAI bus system was created to easily string together multiple components on an offshore wind turbine, making the system design, installation, and commissioning simpler. We did this through a variety of innovations. The first thing we did was define the NAI language for robust and easy communication within the bus. Then we chose Modbus TCP/IP as the mode of communication to the server. A SCADA interface made the information accessible. Secondly, we streamlined the mechanical and electrical interfaces through the entire product line. A standard product footprint simplifies mounting, and a standard electrical interface expedites installation. By stringing the components together, we can be more efficient with cable routing. Lastly, we streamlined the management system, creating a clean line of communication from component to controller to the Parkmaster server and finally to the control center onshore. The process of assigning an IP address at the factory was not practical for large-scale offshore wind farms. There was too much risk in the long journey from factory to installation for a component to land at the wrong location. Therefore, we changed the process so that the NAI system components receive their IP address and configuration once installed during the commissioning process. The system identifies the component, gives it its unique address at its location, and logs it into the system. The NAI bus acts as the backbone of the SABIK offshore system, linking the components together. The gateway facilitates communication between the turbine and the server. The Parkmaster server is the data center. And the SCADA interface provides access for remote monitoring and manual control. There are several fallback measures to make sure that the lights are on and working. A GPS unit on the turbine is pre-programmed according to a defined calendar. Coupling the calendar with the GPS timestamp, the GPS unit triggers all devices and ensures that they turn on and off at the same time. An optional brightness transmitter centrally located in the wind farm monitors the ambient light conditions. If the light levels fall below a pre-programmed level, then the brightness transmitter triggers the system to turn on the lights. As a last resort, each component has a built-in light sensor. If communication is lost in the park network, the light sensor will take over and turn the lantern on when appropriate. Nav aids are critical to safety and therefore always have to work. Therefore, the system has 96 hours of battery backup to ensure that they continue working despite any disruptions. There are two ways to manage this. The first is through a central backup system where the batteries are located in the control cabinet. Alternatively, some products can have the battery directly integrated for a decentral backup system. The NAI system is the only marking system that has been developed specifically for offshore wind farms. It makes installation, configuration, and commissioning simple and easy. Its detailed monitoring capabilities provide precise information for detailed status, control, and diagnostics. Our team is ready to help you design your marking system. SABIK Offshore, your experts in marking offshore wind farms.